Good evening, everyone. So I'll be speaking on balancing mental health during COVID times, or how to manage mental health during this COVID time. Okay. So I think we all know when the central government, state government, when they announced the lockdown, we all had a tough time. Like we don't know what to do. We don't know how to proceed our life. There were a lot of confusions. There were a lot of issues to how to undertake. Maybe I think what I want to really tell you is that this lockdown has really impacted our life in such a way that we are confused, we are stressed, many were depressed, and many were anxious. So I know this lockdown was essential. Maybe other speaker might have already told you this lockdown was essential, but the lockdown has really created problem. Maybe when I talk based on the mental health perspective, I received many calls from my clients saying that what difficulties they have faced during this mental health. So let me quickly move on these slides. What are the areas that the COVID times or lockdown has impacted? The lockdown applied to the three main areas, like physical movement. You might be knowing we were not able to go out. We were not able to do anything outside because the risk was there. The risk was very high. And if at all we go out, it was told to us very clearly that we should maintain social distancing. And we need to maintain social distancing, not only to protect ourselves and our family members, also for the society. And what happened? The basic thing which everyone of should know that restricted availability of most public services while sparing essential services. Now, see, before what happened, we never used to plan for anything. We used to go out, we used to enjoy whatever we want to purchase, we used to purchase, and we were bindas type. We don't have to plan whether where I have to go, how I have to do, whether I will get or not. But after this lockdown, we had restriction of time. This time you have to go out, this time you have to come back, this shop is open only for this time, these services you will get only this time, and many services we could not get because of the lockdown issue. So what happened during this time is that the daily routine which we used to enjoy, the daily routine which we used to follow, the daily routine which we always plan, or maybe from months, days, years, we used to plan. And there is a sudden change we are supposed to do in everything. Like the daily routine where we used to go to work, we used to come back, we used to chat with family members, our work culture, we used to spend time with our friends, we used to go out, hang out, or all the things. Sometime maybe occasionally or weekend, we used to go out, enjoy our meals, but nothing was happening. And that inbuilt fear was also increasing. Like if we go out, what is going to happen? If we step outside, what is going to happen? So, one thing which I want to tell you, I think this my previous speakers, they might have discussed you with this already. Why lockdown? Maybe initially people were not much bothered when they said lockdown because corona cases were very less. And as you know, the cases were increasing. As you know, the cases were very high. We really understand why this lockdown. And maybe after that, slowly the people started understanding the lockdown. People started protecting themselves. People also started why we need to protect ourselves, what methods we need to follow, and how we need to be really careful when we go out, and what we used to do to come back. See, these all things, when we say it is easy, but when we really follow some or the other way, we are stressed because these all are new things we are supposed to follow. These all are something new which added to our personality, added to our life. Many of us, see, I got many calls where they say that this lockdown is really creating hell. This lockdown is really creating problem. This lockdown has really created a mess in their life so that they don't know what to do. Maybe the people, those who really know how to engage themselves, fine, they do good. But people, those who don't know how to spend their time, the people who don't know how to really value the time, I think they really had a tough time. With this, when there are family members, retired people, old age people with the chronic condition, or what I can say, with the major disease or disorder, they really had a tough time because when it comes to medication, all family members were there. Sometimes they don't know what to do because, see, the problem has created in such a way that not only you will agree with me, I feel, even for the minor thing, when you go out and when you come back, always you have a thought, what's going to happen, what I have to do next. So we need to live with all these conditions so that the lockdown has really created a mess in many of us life. Now, so here I would like to share you one thing. the most common emotion faced by all is fear. It makes us anxious, panicky, and can even possibly make us think, say, or do things that we might not consider appropriate under normal circumstances. See, usually what's happening, I want to give you a little explanation here. Fear in the sense, not only the fear of virus. Dear friends, many a time when I get a call from people, they want to communicate, they want to share, they are really in a tough time. See, I got a call where people facing loneliness, stress, and a mild depression. So when all these things are happening, they don't know what to do. They don't know what to discuss. And many a time when they call counselors or professionally psychologists, when they call, what's happening is these family members are not allowing them to talk. Why you're calling somebody? Why you're talking to people and all? What you're discussing? What problems you have? You're okay. You are normal. You're all right. So see, one way the fear is corona. Second way the fear is how to really talk to people, how to really discuss their issues with people. So what happened? The people, those who are already suffering with anxiety or depression, isolation, loneliness, or a mild stress and all, for them, they really had a tough time because during their daily routine, daily life, they used to meet counselor, they used to meet professional psychologist people and all. But now what happened? They cannot freely talk. They cannot freely share. They cannot discuss in a proper way. So this has created one more fear among people. What's happening? See, in return, this fear will affect your mental health. This will affect your mental health in such a way that you should live with it. And see, one day, 2 days, fine. If you have to live with this for days, months together, it will really create a problem in individual. So now, this year, coronavirus has plunged the world into uncertainty, and the constant news about the pandemic can feel relentless. Isolation and remote working can take a huge toll on people's mental health, particularly those already living with chronic condition. So how can to protect this tumultuous period? So here, what I want to really tell you is that this virus has really created a problem. Like virus in the sense corona has really created a problem where one way we are within our house, one way we don't know what to do. And second thing is that it has created a mess on our life. And slowly, where I want to really speak you on how it has really disturbed, created problem to our mental health. So here, mental health. Let me come to a point right now. When we speak about mental health, your mental health influences how you think, feel, and behave in daily life. It also affects your ability to cope with stress, overcome challenges, build relationship, and recover from life setbacks and hardship. So, dear respected all, I want to just tell you here that your mental health depends on how you really think, how you really feel, and how you really behave in daily life. Let me give you an example. If any problem arises, you have to face any problem, it entirely depends on how you deal with the problem, how you deal with the issue. For example, if you feel that somewhere you're tensed, if you feel that somewhere you're stressed, if you feel that people speak bad about you, if you feel that a thought is disturbing you a lot. So the basic point is that whether you live with it or whether you really talk to people or whether you really discuss your difficulties with people, or you feel that, no, it's chalta hai, I will continue with that, let me not discuss with anybody, then what happened? The problem increases. And somewhere or the other way, you create problem for your mental health. And that problem with your mental health is also shown in your physical health. So it's not directly, but what happens, see, the sentence is very clear. Your mental health influences how you think, feel, and behave in daily life. Dear friends, this is very important. When the issue arises, when the issue comes, when you have to deal with the issue, how really you cope with the issue, how really you cope with the daily stress, how you really balance your life. All these things matters because this helps you to have a positive mental health. If you stuck with the thought, or if you continuously think negative about the thought, definitely you will agree with me that one or the other way, it will disturb your mental health. So here, strong mental health. Strong mental health is not just the absence of mental health problems. Being mentally or emotionally healthy is much more than being free of depression and anxiety. or other psychological issues. Rather than the absence of mental illness, mental health refers to the presence of positive characteristics. Dear friends, when we speak about depression or anxiety, we usually say that it is a mental health issues. No, more than that, we all should know that how positive you are, how positively you approach people. See, usually what happened, I know depression, anxiety are the major mental health disorder and it always creates a problem. But when it comes to your mental health, how strong mentally healthy you are, one thing. And second thing, when any problem arises, how you really deal with that. And dear friends, always remember one thing, strong mental health is not just the absence of mental health problem. So your emotions, your expressions, your discussions, your how you take the problem, how you analyze the problem, how you deal with the problem, how positive you are when the problem arises, how positively you deal with the issue, how positively you communicate with you, how positively you motivate yourself, how positively you analyze yourself, how positively you discuss when you are really disturbed. All these things are very important when it comes to a strong mental health. And dear friends, strong mental health in this situation, especially this corona or COVID situation, strong mental health is very important, because in order to deal with simple issues, it can be home, it can be work life, or it can be online classes, or it can be work from home, everything matters a lot. Maybe sometimes we feel that, okay, fine, I can do, but somewhere or the other way, a thought is always disturbing you. And when the thought is disturbing you, how you deal with the thought, that matters a lot. Now, I feel that my previous speakers may also discuss with that. See here, what happened, you might be knowing in the newspaper, media, it is very clearly given. People are walking 1,000 miles, 1,000 kilometers and all, no food, no employment, no bus facilities. People are walking and going. If one way, if that is a problem. Second way, I have interviewed two people who came from Bangalore and some other areas and all. See, they never used to cook. So what happened? They used to purchase one meal and they have to pay a huge amount for that one meal. They used to share and eat in the morning and in the afternoon. Sorry, afternoon and evening. So they had really tough time. Some people, they're at home, they're enjoying lockdown. But if you really read the news, if you really see the media, we could understand what is the traumatic stress faced by the people in one or the other way. We have seen deaths. We have seen the deaths in the road. We have seen people without food. We have seen children, small kids are walking kilometers to reach their destination or to reach their place. We have seen it has affected the community. And we have seen that people are suffering. I know I can't, because it's a really lengthy thing. But when we really see, we can understand how it has really created problem. Maybe, dear friends, for rich people, when we say this, it's something different. But when for poor people, it has really created a mess. So I have, I think recently I have also come across that people are committing suicide because of unemployment. People are committing suicide because of loss of job. People are coming from one place to other saying that I don't have job. I was removed from my job. So see, these all symptoms are really creating stress people. And many people, they don't know whom to approach. Many people, they don't know what to do. And many people, they don't know with whom to approach. See, then what happens? These all things create a mess. These all things create a problem. I think the psychological health is deteriorated. So then what happens? They don't know what happens. So, and one more thing, which I really want to highlight is that, in the last I mentioned, the impact of the lockdown is likely to be the heaviest on those who are alone, poor and psychologically burdened. Friends, I would like to share you one thing here. Many people, as I know, they used to take medication for their psychiatric problems, psychological problems and all. And some, they could not approach doctors. They could not reach doctors. The problem become worse. So these all situations are that. And those who are alone, I don't know whether the right word I am using, their life was really hell. And if you see the media, if you see the newspaper, I think you all might know what the condition the poor people were facing. And what the condition was, you might have seen food problem. You might have seen lot of issues, and we have seen people committing suicide. We have seen people are suffering. So these issues were continuing, and dear friend, if this continue, we'll see lot issues in future days also. So next. How to boost your mental health? I'm coming to my presentation part now. So in order to boost your mental health, you need to have a positive social connection, staying active, managing stress, healthy diet, quality sleep, and special meaning and purpose of your life. Dear friends, what I want to really tell you is that if you really want to boost your physical health, you know what exactly you have to do. But when it comes to mental health, how you are connected. See, when I speak about the connection, it's not that social media connection. It's not about the any other connection. It is how much you talk to people, how much you discuss with people, and what are you doing to stay active. So I've seen many people, they do multitasking. I've seen people, they do art and craft. I've seen people, they prepare articles, they publish their articles. And I've seen people, they have turned and doing pranayama, yoga and all. I've seen people, they have started watching motivational videos so that they can improve their motivation level and all. So when you do all these things, one or the other way, you boost your mental health. And more important thing is that for anything, even it is me and you or anybody, we should understand that what is the meaning of and purpose of my life. That is very important. So automatically what happened when I feel that I have proper meaning for my life, so automatically I work in such a way that I will boost my mental health. And when I boost my mental health, it is very clear that I understand what is the meaning of my life. So dear friends, let me highlight once again. Social connection, staying active, managing stress and healthy diet. And somewhere I have read, which I would like to share you, we're doing multitasking. Multitasking also, it has mentioned somewhere where you take different work and you engage yourself, you keep yourself busy so that no thought will disturb you. No negative thoughts will disturb you. You can engage yourself in such a way that you feel that you are using your time in a very concrete way, in a very rigid way. I think this I don't have to explain. Take a deep breath and reevaluate the situation and do not victimize yourself. See, friends, do not victimizing yourself in the sense, see, we cannot stop spreading corona because this is not in our hand. But there are certain situations in our hand where I can be safe at my home, one thing. And second thing, how I can develop myself during this lockdown, how I can develop myself, how I can do new things, how I can do exciting things, or how I can take up new issues so that I am occupied. See, you are occupied systematically scheduling for yourself, preparing new things and doing some new works and all. I think that really gives a meaning and purpose for your life. Next thing, pause for a moment. It is natural to compare your life with that others, especially when you surf through a social media. And dear friends, I think many a time we come to know that now anyhow, the TikTok is banned and we see that the good people, they come in TikTok, or maybe the bad in the sense, there are bad issues are also happening, good issues are happening in the TikTok. But you might be knowing there were a lot of research were conducted where we see social media. We see the person, people enjoying lavishing things. We see people are going tours in abroad, or they're enjoying their foreign tours and all. And when they buy expensive things and all, they upload it. And they buy any things, they upload it. The good moments, the happy moments, the joyous moments, joyful moments, they upload. So usually what happens when we see this, we are all human beings. We are not animals. We are all human beings. We compare ourselves. Okay, he's doing that. They're enjoying like this. I don't have anything. I'm not enjoying myself. So this what happened, maybe it looks very, when I speak like this, it looks very simple, but it creates a major problem for your mental health. Dear friends, you will believe it or not, sometime this comparison itself will create a problem for you, and it will be a major threat for your mental health. So when I think that moment, you should pause. Instead of comparing, you watch it, you enjoy it. Okay, they are doing it, you should watch it and enjoy it. But how satisfactorily how you can enjoy your life, that is very important. So I'm not, see, dear friends, I'm nobody to tell you whether you should go through social media or not. You enjoy your social media, but never compare yourself with anybody else, because individually you are unique, individually you are good, individually you are strong, and individually you are best for yourself. Then acceptance does not be denial. Denying only delays the process of adjustment. See here, friends, that sometime in our life, when we take up any issues, when we want to learn something especially, we deny it. We deny it. And now the situation is something where we need to accept the situation. Nobody or any one of us, we cannot deny it, because the situation is something where we have to live with it. You cannot say that, no, I don't want to be adjusting myself. I want to go out. I don't want to wear a mask, or I will be like this, like that. No, the situation is something which has, I understand that it's a really created mess in our life, but how you accept the situation and how you really go ahead with the situation, with this problematic situation, that is very important. So then what happened? You will be not denying anything. So denying delays will create a problem. So when you really adjust and when you really go ahead with the situation, I think that is best. And the last thing is that I think you will agree with me, friends. We all use WhatsApp. We are in Facebook. We are in Twitter. And we are in Instagram. And maybe in all the social medias. And especially like me, you all, we all watch news. But it is also said that we cannot trust whatever they share. Many a time I've seen that I get messages through WhatsApp where there is no reality. The fake messages we get. And what happened? The moment we read these fake messages, the fake things goes to our mind and it disturbs a lot. And again, when it disturbs a lot, fear is increased. When the fear is increased, the anxiety level also increased. Maybe then we might be the victim of one or the other issues. So friends, what I really request you is that any news, any simple issues you read, before you judge yourself, before you judge the news, please analyze it in a proper way so that you will come to know whether it is right or wrong. Maybe nowadays you see in the WhatsApp different type of drinks which you used to prepare to stop corona, and the Ayurvedic medicines which stop corona, or this, that, and all. You have to do this, you have to do that. This type of mask you should wear, this type of mask you should not wear. All these things are going on. I understand everything is important, but ultimately it is you who decide what you read, and it is you who decide what you should take and what should leave. Because friends, what happens many a time, this news, what we read many a time, the fake news, what I say, not news, fake news, which really create a problem, and which really, what I can say, which really create problems in such a way that the thought really irritates in our mind, and we follow that. And one day we realize that what I read is completely wrong. It is completely wrong. It is not true. So here, screen time. Dear friends, we all know, we all use mobile. As I said you already, nothing wrong in using anything. Nothing wrong in using any media and all, mobile and all. But friends, I want to ask you one excuse question
me,
here.
Excuse me, sir. I'm sorry to bother you, but we have time constraints. I hope you are winding up in 2 minutes.
Oh my goodness.
Please.
Okay.
Please.
Okay.
Yeah.
When we speak about the screen time, are we really aware about how much time, how much seconds, how much minutes I really spend in a day in watching the screen? So the addiction level increases, and this also creates a problem. Since I have to rush down, I think, see, if you have a mental health condition, I wanted to present this, but see, this information is already there in WHO website. You can go through it. And see here, balancing. See, now usually people say balancing life. Now, what is balancing life is, you should depend on yourself. That is very important. You don't have to compare yourself with anybody else. You don't have to compare yourself saying that, okay, in their house that is happening, he's enjoying like this. So how you balance your life. See, as you balance your life, your mental health also balance. And you feel that you are a balance. As you see that balanced diet, you feel that you are a balanced person. So friends, what you need to do is, in order to balance your life, you need to find new priorities. But dear friends, don't see that. Don't simply put new priorities so that you have more problems since I have to rush up. Okay, now tips to keep your balance or rebalance yourself. Friends, very important thing is that please value yourself. Remember, you are important in every situation. You are important. How you deal with the situation, how you deal with the problem, how you take the problem and how you respond it, very important. Next, very important, in this time, take care of your body, especially take care of your mental health. Surround yourself with good people. See, my doesn't mean that there are bad people. There are bad people, there are good people. But how nicely you interact with good people. And dear friends, don't ask me who are good. No, it is you have to decide who is good, who is bad. Then learn how to deal with stress or call professional and seek help from them. Dear friend, this point I want to really highlight. Whenever you feel that a thought is disturbing you, whenever you feel that you are anxious, whenever you feel that you are stressed, please feel free either to call a counselor or a psychologist. I think they can guide you. They can help you in a better way. Quiet your mind. Quiet your mind in a sense, not shutting your mind. It only thing is that always analyze yourself. Always think yourself before you do anything. And friends, again, I'm repeating that. Get help when you need it. So with this, I conclude. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Mental health depends on how you think, how you feel, and how you behave. And Dr. Matthias has very clearly explained it. And we are so thankful to you, sir, because what we think and how we behave and what we feel really matters how we go about with the situation. And at such times, there are teachings of social distancing everywhere. But I think we have to also keep it at a physical distancing level, but we have to be connected to our close ones, our friends, and so on, in order to avoid stress. And one thing which Sarah has really has mentioned is that about fake message. Yes, we need to know, knowledge is very much important, but fake messages can really create stress. And so I think avoidance of media can also help us if a person is going through mental stress. We can take one quick question from the audience. One quick question, yes.
Sir, there is a question on screen by Jalpa Shah.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, please, you are, Kiran. There is a question, what should we do in trauma situation?
Dr. Matthias, please.
Yes, yes. Can you please come again? Oh, okay, what should we do in trauma? See, I want to tell you one thing. See, when you say trauma, there are different ways to analyze it. Trauma situation is something where I think you will agree with me. You will undergo a severe stress. Am I right? Or you will undergo a severe issues and all. Friends, what I really want to tell you, trauma in the sense which is very difficult to deal with the situation, I think that is a situation you need to consult people. See, sometimes I make it very simple for you. Many a time what we think is, if any issues are happening, we live with it. We don't bother to discuss with people. We don't bother to act on it. So usually, I always tell you one thing. You said since trauma situation, see, it is very important for you what type of trauma you are facing. That is very important. Mm-hmm. See, in psychology, trauma means the different areas. So in this trauma situation, see, I really request you that you need to take immediate help from the people, those with whom you are surrounding. And second important thing is that it is the right time for you to meet professional people. And see, I cannot explain you because there are other people are waiting, I feel that. So when it comes to trauma, you need to act out immediately. Act out immediately in the sense you need to analyze the situation first and you need to consult the right person. I think that only will help you to come out. Why I'm saying this? Because many a time, what mistake we do is we talk to friends and we talk to people who doesn't know about anything about this trauma. So what happened? They give some suggestion and dear friends, believe me that will not help you. That will not help you at all. So you need to really consult to a right person. I think they give you proper guidance. And friends, why I'm saying proper guidance? Because sometimes your situation may have to undergo a therapeutic process, and that therapeutic process might have to turn into a proper medication. I hope I answered your question. I think with this short duration,
yeah,
I have answered. I'm very sorry for that. I have to give a lengthy answer, but it's a short.
You made it very clear, sir. You made it very clear. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah. Very much.